dear students, I am Krishnamraju Varikuppala, faculty in physics, IIIT Basel. Today we are going to discuss about units and measurements. Already we have discussed about base quantities and their units. In this class we are going to discuss about accuracy, precision and different kinds of errors, and also we will see absolute error, relative error and percentage error here. And also we will discuss about combination of errors. And errors when we are performing addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. So we will go with one by one. See here, what is meant by accuracy? Accuracy is nothing but, if you want to measure anything, that measured value, accuracy tells us how close the measured value is to its true value. True value ki enta daggaraga untundi measured value anedi cheptund annat accuracy. Next, we are going to discuss about precision. Precision tells us to what resolution or limit the quantity is measured. For example, I am giving a chartist to you, and I am saying that its true value is something 4.468 centimeters. This is true value of chartist here. I am saying that it is a true value of chartist and its length is 4.468. I am giving you three different kinds of equipment. One is ordinary scale. I am giving you ordinary scale, and another is vernier calipers, and one more is screw gauge. You know, I told you already, the least count is nothing but the smallest value that we can measure by using any equipment is called as the least count. Once again, least count is the smallest value that we can measure by using any instrument. For example, if we take the ordinary scale, you will be seeing like this. 15 centimeters on ordinary scale is kunam ankonde. Suppose 0 value, 1, 2 centimeters, 3 centimeters, 4 and etc. up to 15 centimeters. In between 0 and 1, we will be having 10 more divisions. How many divisions? 10 more divisions. See, each division indicates 1 millimeter. So here the least count of ordinary scale is how much? 1 millimeter. Which is equal to, in centimeters, 1 millimeter is nothing but 0.1 centimeter. Similarly, the least count of vernier calipers is 0.01 centimeters. And the least count of screw gauge is 0.001 centimeters. Okay? So here, I am giving you the chartpiece and asked you to measure the length of the chartpiece by using ordinary scale, vernier calipers and screw gauge. I gave this chartpiece to student one teacher. He measured the length of the chartpiece and he told me it is 4.6 centimeters. He's saying 4.6 centimeters. He should not tell me like this, 4.62 centimeters or 4.61 centimeters like this. Because in this ordinary scale, we have a least count of 0.1 centimeter. That means we can go up to one decimal digit after the decimal point. We can go up to one digit after the decimal point. So expressing the measured value like this by using ordinary scale is wrong. We should go up to only one digit after decimal point. So he told me that the length of the chalk piece is 4.6 centimeters. And student number two, I gave him vernier calipers to different student, and I gave him the chalk piece and I asked him to measure the length of the chalk piece. He measured it as the length of the chalk piece. He told me it as 4.45 centimeters. Why I am expressing two digits after decimal point? Because we can go up to the resolution of two decimal digits. Okay. Now, here come to screw gauge. And I gave the chalk piece to third student who has screw gauge in his hands. Okay. Now, the screw gauge least count is 0.001 centimeter. Now, he measured the length as 4.365 centimeters. 365 centimeters. See here, he expressed the value as 4.365 centimeters. That is 3 decimal digits. He expressed a value up to 3 decimal digits here. So, now, when you compare all these three values, length of the chalk piece using ordinary scale, length of the chalk piece using vernier calipers, and length of the chalk piece using screw gauge. What is the true value here? 4.468. Among these three values, which one is more close to the true value? Which measured value is more to the true value? 4.46, 4.45. This is the closest one to true value. So, this is more accurate. This is accurate. Accurate. But not precise. But not precise. Why it is not precise? Because we can go up to two decimal digits by using vernier calipers. When we come to here, its value is 4.365. That means less accurate. Less accurate, but more precise. Why it is more precise? Because we can go up to three decimal digits after decimal point. That is, we can go up to resolution of three digits after decimal point. That is, we can go up to a limit of three digits after decimal point. So, screw gauge is more precise device than ordinary scale. So, this one is less accurate because 4.365 is not close to true value. So, it is not accurate but precise one because the limit of resolution is more in this case of screw gauge. Right. See here, I am using a vernier calipers to measure the length of marker here. Vernier calipers to measure the length of a marker. See here, least count of vernier calipers is how much? 0.01 centimeter. Okay, I am giving the marker to measure the length of marker using vernier calipers. Someone is measuring. I asked him to take 5 values, 5 different measurements. He may measure the first one value as 14.24 centimeters. And I asked him to repeat the same measurement. Next time he may get his as 14.23 centimeters. And third time he get the value as 14.26 centimeters. And fourth time he may get it as 14.25 centimeters. And fifth time he measure the value as 4.24 centimeters again. Here. Are these values changing? 142, 142, 142. are same in every measurement. So what is changing here? This value is changing. This value is changing. This is changing. This is changing. So these digits are called as uncertain digit. What we call them as? Uncertain digit. Because the error is present in the second digit after decimal point. Why only second digit is changing after decimal point? Because our least count falls at second digit after decimal point. So here, these three digits are called as certain digits. These three are not changing while the measurement is going on, but the last digit is keep on changing because of error. We will discuss what are errors later. So here, these three digits are constant, so we call them as certain digits, and the changing digit is called as the uncertain digit. Here, uncertain is nothing but error. Uncertainty and error both are same. So error is present in second digit after decimal point. Okay, so see here, the errors. Why we are getting errors in this case here? See, we will see here. Errors are different types. Systematic errors and random errors. We'll be having two types of errors. One is systematic errors and random errors. Okay, so systematic errors arises due to error in the instrument. Instrument lo error undanukondi. So the measured value is also having some error. Suppose if you go to the supermarket and ask shopkeeper to give 1 kg of sugar. He immediately give you 1 kg of sugar by measuring the weight on the balance. If the balance is initially not set to zero, the shopkeeper also does not know how to set it to zero. In that case, the instrument itself is having some initial error. That errors are called as the errors due to instrument. And another one is nothing but, if you don't know the procedure exactly how to measure the value, so imperfection in procedure, we will get errors due to imperfection in procedure. If you don't know exact procedure how to measure the value of a given quantity, we will get the error also. So such kind of error, we call it them as imperfection in procedure. And third one is nothing but personal errors. Personal errors. This is arises because of personal errors. And if some people may have different vision, because of parallax error and because of sight, we will get errors. These type of errors, all these three types of errors comes under systematic errors. Once again, the systematic errors are mainly because of instrumental errors, imperfection in knowing the procedure, and third one is nothing but personal error. And another type of errors are nothing but here, random errors. If we are measuring the value of any quantity, if the situations around us changes suddenly, randomly, such kind error will be occurred in the measurement. Such kind of errors, we call them as random errors. Okay, if we are measuring, if we are experimenting on the Boyle's law is nothing but pressure into volume equal to constant at a constant temperature. While we are at constant temperature should be constant. When we are performing Boyle's law, that is pressure is inversely proportional to volume, in order to prove pressure is inversely proportional to volume, we should keep the temperature as constant. If the room temperature increases suddenly, we cannot do anything. The Boyle's law will not be proved correctly. Such type of change in temperature arises abruptly or drastically. That change in temperature occurs randomly. So that these type of errors arises in that case. So these errors are called as random errors. Suppose let the measured values of a physical quantity. Physical quantity may be anything, length, volume, area, or anything. Suppose a physical quantity I measured it as 5 different types: A1, A2, A3, A4, A5. I measured the same physical quantity 5 times. Why I am measuring 5 times here? Because in order to get the accurate value, we should measure the physical quantity as many times as we can. And I am taking the average of all these 5 measurements. Here average or mean of measurements. Mean of measurements is given by A1 plus A2 plus A3 plus A4 plus A5. Sum of the measured values divided by total number of measured values is nothing but average value or mean value here. So this measured value, A average or A mean, is called as true value. How can we get true value of the measurement? By taking the average of all measured values is nothing but true value of any measurement. Okay, here we got true value here. True value is nothing but average of all measurements is nothing but true value. Now here I am going to define absolute error. Absolute error. See here, absolute error is nothing but it is the magnitude of difference between true value and measured value. True value and measured value. See here. So it is indicated with absolute error, indicated with delta symbol. Indicated with delta. Because it is difference of true value and measured value. So here absolute error is nothing but. So absolute error is equal to magnitude of, and absolute error is always positive. We should take the magnitude of difference between true value and measured value. Here, what is true value? True value is nothing but a mean or average value. So difference, true value is nothing but mean value of all 5 measured quantities. Difference and minus sign of difference between true value and measured value. What is the first measured value? A1. So a mean minus A1 is nothing but first absolute error. Absolute error in the first measured quantity A1 is nothing but delta A1 equal to a mean minus A1. Similarly, absolute error in the second measured quantity. What is second measured quantity? A2. What is absolute error in it? Delta A2 is equal to true value or mean value minus measured value. And delta A3 similarly is equal to A mean minus A3. Absolute error in the fourth measured quantity, delta A4, equal to true value minus its measured value A4. Similarly, delta A5 is equal to A mean minus A5. Absolute error in the fifth measured value is nothing but true value. Difference of true value and measured value is nothing but absolute error. Okay, I am taking the mean of all absolute errors. So, mean of absolute errors. Mean of all absolute errors. What are absolute errors here? Delta A1, delta A2, delta A3, delta A4, delta A5 are absolute errors. I am taking the mean absolute error. Mean of all absolute errors. A mean, delta A mean equal to delta A1 plus delta A2 plus delta A3 plus delta A4 plus delta A5 divided by 5. Divided by 5. So here any value, any measurement can be expressed as measurement of A can be expressed as its true value and its error. So measurement of A equal to its true value plus or minus and error. That means every measurement will be having some error. Here delta A mean is nothing but absolute error here. What is absolute error? It is the magnitude of difference between true value and measured value. That means absolute error is always positive. Okay, just now we have discussed that any measurement can be expressed as, that is measurement of A is expressed as its true value plus or minus error, its error. Okay, so here we are going to define one more error, different kind of error, that is a relative error. Relative error. It is the relative error is the ratio of mean absolute error. Mean absolute error to its true value. True value is nothing but mean value. Mean value. That is relative error equal to mean absolute error is nothing but delta A mean divided by A mean. This is relative error. Okay. Now, percentage error. If you want to express the relative error in percentage, so we will discuss about percentage error now. Percentage error is nothing but relative error multiplied by 100 is nothing but percentage error. Now, the percentage error is given by percentage error equal to relative error into 100. That is, percentage error equal to relative error is nothing but delta A mean divided by A mean into 100 is nothing but percentage error. Students, now we are going to discuss about combination of errors. That is, when we are performing an experiment, it involves different kinds of measurements. Suppose if we want to measure the volume of a cuboid, that means I have to measure the length, breadth and height. So here, after measuring the length, breadth and height, we need to perform multiplication between them. That is, volume of a cuboid is nothing but length into breadth into height. We need to perform multiplication here. And another example is, if I want to measure the density of anything, density of a substance, density of water, in that case, I need to measure mass and volume it occupies. So now, density of water is defined as mass of the water divided by volume it occupies. That means density equal to mass divided by volume. Here we are performing division here. That is, to measure the any physical quantity, we should calculate the errors when they are combining. Like when we are performing multiplication or addition or subtraction or division, there will be certain rules to be followed. Okay, that is, we are going to discuss about combination of errors now. See here, for addition or subtraction, first one that we are going to discuss is addition or subtraction. For addition and subtraction, the rule is same. While combining addition or subtraction, the rule will be same. Suppose if we have a two physical quantities, measured values. Suppose I measure a quantity A as its true value plus or minus its error. True value plus or minus error. Similarly, another quantity is B. B can be expressed as its true value plus or minus its error is delta B. Okay. Now, I would like to combine them with addition. So, consider the resultant. What we are performing here? Addition. The resultant Z is equal to A plus B. A plus B. Here, measurement of A is having error and measurement of B is also having error. If two measurements are having error, the result also will be having error in it. Okay, so this can be written as Z, its true value is Z, and error in it is given by plus or minus delta Z. Z is true value of resultant and delta Z is nothing but error in the true value, resultant value of, error in the resultant value. So Z plus or minus delta Z equal to A plus B. A is nothing but A plus or minus delta A and B is nothing but measured value of B can be expressed as its true value plus or minus its error, that is B plus or minus delta B. Okay, so now Z plus or minus delta Z is equal to A plus B, A plus B, plus or minus common this one. What is the remaining thing? Delta A plus delta B. So here, Z is nothing but what? A plus B. Resultant of A and B is nothing but Z. So what is here delta Z? Here delta Z is nothing but delta Z equal to delta A plus delta B. That is error in resultant. Error in resultant. Resultant is nothing but sum of two measurements. Error in resultant is delta Z is equal to delta A plus delta B. What is delta? Absolute. Delta Z is nothing but absolute error in resultant value is equal to sum of absolute errors of individual quantities. What is the rule here? The rule is when two quantities are, two physical quantities or measured quantities are added or subtracted, when two physical quantities are added or subtracted, the final resultant error, final resultant error equal to is equal to the sum of absolute errors of individual quantities. Absolute errors of individual quantities. Okay. When two quantities are being added or subtracted, the final result will be having some error. What is the final result? Absolute error in the final result. Absolute error. Okay. When two quantities are added or subtracted, the absolute error in the final result, absolute error in the final resultant is equal to sum of absolute errors of individual quantities. That is, absolute error in the final resultant is equal to summation of absolute error of A and absolute error of B. This is the definition.
One, go.
Students, we see an example here. Just now we have discussed that in combination of errors, we have discussed the rule for addition or subtraction. Addition or subtraction will be having same rule. That is, when two physical quantities are added or subtracted, the absolute error in the final result is equal to the sum of absolute errors of the individual quantities. The principle is same for addition as well as subtraction, that is delta z. Absolute error in the final result is equal to sum of absolute errors in the individual quantities. This is error in the final result. In this way, we can calculate error in the final result. Now, see, our actual question is, as given that the temperatures of two bodies measured are T1 equal to 20 degrees Celsius. Its true value is 20 degrees Celsius and absolute error is 0.5 degrees Celsius. And T2 is equal to true value is 50 degrees Celsius and absolute error is in it is 0.5 degrees Celsius. Now, he asked us to calculate temperature difference, that is subtraction of T2 and T1. He asked us to find out temperature difference and error in them. Now I am performing, the solution is nothing but like this. The solution is, so he asked us to find out T2 minus T1, temperature difference, is equal to, what is T2? 50 degrees Celsius plus or minus 0.5 degrees Celsius minus 20 degrees Celsius plus or minus 0.5 degrees Celsius. Okay? So, the difference of true value is nothing but 50 minus 20, 30 degrees Celsius. So, now we should find out the error in the resultant value. ఎర్రర్ ఏముంది ఇక్కడ 0.5 మైనస్ 0.5 చేసినాం అనుకోండి, ఎర్రర్ ఏమొస్తుంది? వీ విల్ గెట్ జీరో ఎర్రర్. ఇట్ ఈస్ నాట్ ట్రూ, బికాస్ ద ఫైనల్, వాట్ ఈస్ ద రిజల్టెంట్, వాట్ ఈస్ ద డెఫినేషన్ ఫర్ కాంబినేషన్ ఆఫ్ ఎర్రర్స్ వెన్ వీ యాడ్ ఆర్ సబ్ట్రాక్ట్, ద అబ్సల్యూట్ ఎర్రర్ ఇన్ ద ఫైనల్ రిజల్ట్ ఈస్ ద సమ్ ఆఫ్ అబ్సల్యూట్ ఎర్రర్స్ ఆఫ్ ద ఇండివిజువల్ క్వాంటిటీస్ వెదర్ ఇట్ ఈస్ అడిషన్ ఆర్ సబ్ట్రాక్షన్. సో ఇది మైనస్ చేసిన అనుకోండి, 0.5 మైనస్ 0.5, దట్ మీన్స్ జీరో ఎర్రర్ వచ్చింది అనుకోండి. నో ఇన్స్ట్రుమెంట్ విల్ బి హ్యావింగ్ ఎర్రర్ విత్ జీరో. ఎనీ ఎక్విప్మెంట్ ఆర్ ఎనీ పర్సన్ కెన్ డూ మిస్టేక్స్ ఆర్ ఎర్రర్స్ వైల్ పర్ఫార్మింగ్ ఎన్ ఎక్స్పెరిమెంట్. సో దేర్ షుడ్ బి కంపల్సరీ అన్ ఎర్రర్. సో మైనస్ చేయకూడదు ఇక్కడ. వాట్ ఈస్ ద ఎర్రర్ ఇన్ ద రిజల్టెంట్ వాల్యూ? సో అబ్సల్యూట్ ఎర్రర్ ఇన్ ద రిజల్టెంట్ వాల్యూ ఈక్వల్ టు సమ్ ఆఫ్ అబ్సల్యూట్ ఎర్రర్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ వాల్యూ and absolute error in this value, that is 0.5 delta A plus delta B, that means 0.5 degrees Celsius. So the temperature difference is equal to T2 minus T1 equal to 30 degrees Celsius plus or minus 1 degree Celsius. So this is the final answer. Okay, now is a question. He has given T1 and T2 and asked us to find out sum. Calculate temperature summation and error in them. Summation adigand ankoldi. Appude em cheyali? T1 plus T2. When we add T1 plus T2, that is 50 degrees Celsius plus or minus 0.5 degrees Celsius plus 20 degrees Celsius plus or minus 0.5 degrees Celsius. That means T1 plus T2 is equal to 50 plus 20, 70 degrees Celsius. True value 70 degrees Celsius and absolute error in the resultant summation. Resultant equal to absolute error in the resultant equal to sum of absolute errors of individual quantities. That is nothing but 0.5 summation of 0.5 and 0.5 degrees Celsius. That is, the final answer is 70 degrees Celsius plus or minus 1 degree Celsius. So, when we are adding errors, the rule is saying, that is, whether we are performing subtraction or addition, the absolute error in the final resultant value is equal to sum of absolute errors of individual quantities. Okay? Okay, students, here we are going to discuss about error of a product or quotient or division. That is nothing but here, let us consider measured value of A is A plus or minus delta A, and measure value of B is B plus or minus delta B. Now we are going to discuss about error of a product. That means error when we are performing multiplication, or error of a quotient, that is error while we are performing division. So here the rule is same for product as well as quotient. So similarly, we have discussed about error in the combination of addition or subtraction. Addition, subtraction will be having same rule, and here multiplication and division will be having same rule. Here we are going to perform product, that is multiplication. The resultant of measured values A and B, that is given by A into B like this. Every measured value will be having some error. So resultant is also having some error. That means Z plus or minus delta Z is equal to A. A means measured value of A is A plus or minus delta A, and measured value of B is B plus or minus delta B. So now multiply these two. So A into, multiplying A with these two, and then multiplying delta A with these two. Now I am performing multiplication of A into B plus or minus delta B. Okay, now plus or minus delta A into B plus or minus delta B. Now A into B, AB plus or minus A delta B, A delta B. Now plus or minus delta A into B, that is plus or minus delta A into B. Now plus or minus delta A into delta B, delta A into delta B. Okay, this is nothing but Z plus or minus delta Z. I am dividing both sides with, dividing both sides with AB. Here I am dividing with AB. Here is also I am dividing with AB. A into B. Here A into B is nothing but what? Z. So I am writing it as Z plus or minus delta Z divided by A into B. A into B is nothing but Z. That is equal to, simply I am distributing AB divided by AB plus or minus A delta B divided by AB, A delta B divided by AB. Now plus or minus delta A into B divided by AB, AB plus or minus delta A into delta B divided by A into B, delta A into delta B divided by A into B. Okay, now we will be getting like this. AB and AB cancels out. Here A and A cancel out. Here B and B will be cancelling out. Okay, now I am writing like this. Here Z by Z, Z by Z is nothing but Z divided by Z plus or minus delta Z divided by Z is equal to, here we will get 1 plus, what we are getting here, delta B divided by B plus or minus delta A divided by A plus or minus delta A by A is nothing but absolute error by true value, is called relative error. Relative error in A into relative error in B. Relative error is nothing but delta A by A is very small value. Multiplication of two small values, we will get further more small value. That is nothing but we can neglect this term. Neglect this term. Because by performing multiplication between two small values, that is, example 0.1 into 0.1 ankonde, we will get 0.0001, the smallest value. so that we can neglect this last term. So I have written these three terms here. Okay, so finally delta z by z is nothing but 1. 1 and this 1 cancels out. So what is the remaining here? So here 1, z by z is nothing but 1, delta z by z is equal to 1 plus or minus, I'm taking common as plus or minus, so delta a by a plus delta a plus delta b by b. Here 1 is here, 1 is there. Delta z by z is equal to delta a by a plus delta b by b. So I am concluding here as delta z by z equal to delta a by a plus delta b by b. What is the rule here? When we are performing product or quotient, when we are performing multiplication or division, the relative error in the final result is equal to delta a by a is nothing but relative error in a, delta b by b is nothing but relative error in b, so delta z by z is nothing but relative error in final result. So when two quantities are multiplied or divided, the relative error in the final result is equal to sum of relative errors of individual quantities. Once again, when two quantities are divided or multiplied, the relative error, delta z by z is nothing but relative error, the relative error in the resultant is equal to sum of relative errors of the individual quantities. Once again, I am reminding you, repeating, when we are performing addition or subtraction, we take absolute error. Absolute error in the final result equal to sum of absolute errors of the individual quantities. When we are performing multiplication or division, we should take the relative error. That is, when two quantities are multiplied or divided, the relative error in the final resultant is equal to sum of relative errors of the individual quantities. I am writing definition here, concluding the definition here. That is, when two quantities are multiplied or divided, what we got? The relative error. Relative error in the result is equal to sum of relative errors in the individual quantities. Sum of relative errors in the individual quantities. That is delta z by z, relative error in the resultant is equal to relative error in A plus relative error in B. Here we will discuss a problem on this rule. That is, the result R equal to V by I. Here the two quantities are being measured, that is voltage V equal to 100 plus or minus 5 and current I equal to 10 plus or minus 0.2, true value, and it is mean absolute error. True value of current is 10, absolute error in the current is 0.2 amperes. Here two quantities are V and I are in the relation of division. So when we are performing multiplication or division, we should take this formula. That is, relative error in the resultant is equal to sum of relative errors of the individual quantities. So he asked us to find the percentage error. Before finding out percentage error, we should find out the relative error. When relative error is being multiplied by 100, we will get percentage error. So first we should find out R, relative error in R. Relative error in R is nothing but R is final resultant of division of voltage and current. So relative error in R, that is delta R by R, is equal to V. Measure value of V is nothing but its absolute error is 5 and the true value is 100, that is delta V by V. This value is nothing but V and this is delta V. Similarly, this value is nothing but I and this is delta I. Okay, so what is our formula? Relative error in the final resultant, that is relative error in R is nothing but delta R by R equal to sum of relative error of V and I, that is delta V by V plus delta I by I. So that is delta R by R, relative error in R is equal to delta V by V. What is delta V? 5 divided by V is how much? 100 plus delta I by I. What is delta I here? Delta I is equal to 0.2 divided by I. I is 10. Okay, so that is here 5 by 100 plus 0.2 ni 10th one multiply chestna ikkada 10th one divide chestna 10th one multiply chesi divide chestna 0.2 into 10 is nothing but 2 divided by 10 into 10 is nothing but 100. Now delta R by R is equal to 5 by 100 plus 2 by 100 is nothing but 7 by 100. Now percentage error, percentage error is given by relative error into 100, that is percentage error equal to what is relative error? What we got as the relative error? 7 by 100. 7 by 100 into 100. So what is the percentage error here? 7 is the percentage error in resistance R. Dear students, carefully write down the notes of all the video lecture and do practice the examples also. Thank you. Have a wonderful day.